Greetings to you, dear pupils and parents. It's a wonderful experience working with you through this medium. We call on you to be attentive and follow this lesson keenly so that you can understand and do your exercises at the end. Have a nice time learning. We will be right back.
Good afternoon, class 4 pupils. My name is Ngurene Njoya. I will be taking you still on science and technology and this time around environmental science. And before we get to our lesson, I would love that we remind ourselves of the past lesson. During our last class, we had a lesson on pollution. So to help us move fast, you are going to answer these questions. The first question, what is pollution? Good. Pollution is the addition of harmful substances in our environment, making the environment unsafe for living things. The second question, how do we call these harmful substances that make the environment unsafe for living things? Good, they are called pollutants. Beautiful. Now we're going to move straight to our lesson of today. And before we get to our lesson of today, we're going to observe the chart. So we're going to observe a chart. You observe the chart very well, and you observe and take note of what is happening. Beautiful. So, we have observed the chart, and I will ask these questions for us to answer. The first question, what have we seen on the chart? Yes, you have seen a car. Beautiful. Now, when you look at the car, I would love you to look at the chart again. When you look at the car, you will discover that the exhaust pipe is sending out something very, very dark. So what do you think is that? Yes. We call it exhaust fumes. Exhaust fumes. And now, where do you think this exhaust fume is moving to? Yes, to the atmosphere, to the air that we breathe, yes. Beautiful. And now, what do you think will happen to the air as the exhaust fume is moving to the air? It is going to pollute the air. It is going to pollute the air. Now, it therefore means that this exhaust fume is an air pollutant. So, can we name some other examples of air pollutants? Yes? Thank you. We have dust particles. We have poisonous gases, and so on and so forth. Thank you. So those are some examples of air pollutant. So our lesson of today will be focusing on air pollution. Air pollution. Now, before we continue with the objectives, I would love us to name some of the ways through which we can prevent air pollution. How can we prevent air pollution? Yes? Good. We should avoid burning bushes. Yes? We should avoid using second-handed vehicles. Good. So these are some of the ways through which we can prevent air pollution. So right away, we're not going to waste much time. We'll go straight to our summary notes. And this is our summary notes on the board. We have here, what is air pollution? We are reading together. We say air pollution is the process of making the air unsafe for living things. The second point, under that, we say smoke, exhaust fumes, like what we saw coming out from the car. Smoke, exhaust fumes, dust particles, and poisonous gases are some examples of air pollutants. Our next point, we are going to be looking at the effects of air pollution. What are some of the effects of air pollution? The first point, it leads to the spread of airborne diseases. The second point, it causes lung cancer, asthma, etc. The third point, it causes irritation and a headache. And lastly, it causes acidic rain that destroys crops. So these are some of the effects of air pollution. There are others. Now, we're going to look at some of the ways we can prevent, we can use to prevent air pollution. Prevention of air pollution. Prevention of air pollution. Everybody, there was a mistake there. So we correct. Prevention of air pollution, not airborne diseases. We are going to take airborne diseases. Take note. Prevention of air pollution. The first point, exhaust pipes of vehicles should be cleaned regularly. The second point, avoid burning plastic tires in open air. The third point, waste should be burned in an incinerator. The fourth point, avoid buying second-handed vehicles, refrigerators, etc. So these are some of the ways that we can use to prevent air pollution. And I would like to emphasize on the word incinerator, because some people would ask, what is an incinerator? An incinerator is a closed place without having the smoke coming out to pollute the air. So Thank you for being attentive. And before I go, I would love that we have some few questions. We are still going to have our questions through dictation. I believe that you have been doing dictation and spelling in English language. I'm going to give you a few questions that you're going to answer. Our first question. You copy the questions down. Question number one. Exhaust fume is an air pollutant. True or false? The second question. State two effects. I repeat again. State two effects of air pollution. The next question. Give one way through which air pollution can be prevented. Thank you. See you in our next class.
Hello, dear pupils and parents. Thank you for following the lesson till the end, and we hope you enjoyed it. For your questions and exercises, write them down and send to us through the email info@teachconnect.org. The teacher will answer your questions, correct your exercises, and send them back to you. Thank you for working with us.